with certain fruitful ideas. That is why a number of the incubation and innovation cells are being developed in a lot of technical institutions nowadays, so that all these students are exposed to certain ideas which will be beneficial for rooting out the problems of the society. Apart from this, one thing which is very important is the exposed interaction, which is very important. As you all are aware, that there are small problems of the industries which can be solved by our academic institutions, but for which you have to have a greater connectivity with the industries, so that industries can have trust, can have faith in the academic institutions, so that those small problems can be solved by our young youth. So that culture is also to be promoted in the academic institution, and that bonding is also to be strengthened. Because unless and until our industry is not growing, we will not be in a position to provide the employment to large population of the country, as population is a big issue nowadays in the country. And this is not going to come down as per the policies. You have to come up with certain policies. So ultimately, job creation will be our focus, and we will have to produce the entrepreneurs which will be looking for providing the jobs, not they are looking for the jobs for themselves. With these words, I'm confident that the Mirza sir is having wide exposure. He has been executive director in BHEL also. So he's having versatile experience, and now he's looking such an important office in Government of India in Niti Aayog, that his experience will definitely be benefited to the participants, and they will come up with certain new dimensions in their thinking, and it will be definitely helpful in their career. It will be definitely helpful for the society as a whole, for reducing the problems in the society. With these words, I am thankful to the organizing team, specifically Atal Incubation Center, Niti Aayog, SPIU, BIT Jhansi in Innovation Incubation Cell, for arranging such a nice national webinar, in which I was just having a look on the profile of the participants. So I came to know that more than 600 participants joined through different platforms, and across the almost all the states of the country. So that is just a beginning, as Mr. Mirza has just pointed out, that it's just a beginning, and we will go a long way for contributing for the welfare of the society. With these words, I wish success for this webinar. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much, sir, for your motivation, guidance, and moral support. Your influence can never be erased. Learning and innovation go hand in hand. The arrogance of success is to think that what you did yesterday will be sufficient for tomorrow. There is a way to do it better. Find it. You say this, sir. Your motivational presence matters a lot to us. Thank you, sir, for being with us on this beautiful day. Going ahead, let me shortly take you to the MOU which we have between AIC EMPI and BIT Jhansi. AIC EMPI New Delhi and BIT Jhansi has signed an MOU on 25th August 2020 for 3 years, virtually with mutual agreement. The main focus of this MOU best suits to the theme of this webinar. This MOU will be helpful for encouraging students, faculty members for innovation, incubation, startups, entrepreneurship. Let me shortly highlight the key points of this MOU. AIC EMPI responsibilities are provision of space, facilities, and infrastructure, selection and training of entrepreneurs, assisting entrepreneurs to bring their ideas to proof of concept, prototype, field testing stage, assisting entrepreneurs with finance, marketing, legal, HR, and other functions, setting up of demonstration units, training and brand business promotion and engagement with the relevant organizations at the national and international levels. Enable an exchange platform for understanding respective best practices, facilitating policy studies, roundtables, workshops, etc., with a view to generate appropriate inputs and suggestions to the Government of India for the policy initiatives and other matters as may be mutually agreed. Now let's see BIT responsibilities in this MOU. Outline the areas in which it would like to assist AIC-EMPI, providing guidance and support for the new startups through knowledge support to incubators, development of required hardware and software solutions at laboratories, training, mentoring, and skill development in electricity, mobility, renewables, IoT, and other areas of interest, assisting participating entrepreneurs to access potential ideas, mentors, supporting fundraising from director and or other funding or participating entrepreneurs, other matters as may be mutually agreed. Now let's see joint responsibilities of this MOU among BIT Jhansi and AIC-EMPI. To organize and conduct collaborative events like seminar, workshops, training programs, pitching sessions, taking up pilot projects together or in partnership with others to showcase, demonstrate, and validate new technologies, concepts, and solutions with a view to exploring suitability for introduction in India, sharing of specialized facilities, scaling up of select final year projects. I hope and wish this MOU will be fruitful for the students and faculty members. Now let's move ahead with the session. Leaders are by definition change makers, that is transformers. When you are called to lead, you are called to advance, move forward and improve the situation. You can't solve a problem on the same level that it was created. Leaders are by definition. You have to rise above it to the next level, he says and believes. Yes, we have such a dynamic personality. The whole digital platform is vibrating and echoing his prominence. Chief guest and also a technical keynote speaker of this webinar, Mr. Vinod Midha, CEO, Achal Incubation Center, EMPI, New Delhi. An alumnus of IIT Delhi with rich experience of 37 plus years with Bharat Heavy Electricals Limited and held coveted positions as Executive Director and Additional General Manager. Presently, he is Global Business Development Advisor of Aston Field Renewables. His areas of expertise are marketing and business development, including development and introduction of new products in steel, mining, captive power, defense, and renewable energy, project engineering, automation and control, commissioning, project management, procurement, vigilance, etc., corporate functions, support, capital investment, technology acquisition, HR, PR, industry coordination. Mr. Midha is passionate about innovative use of renewable energy to change the lives of people even in remote corners of the country. Also, Mr. Midha conceptualized and built the framework for India's first and world's largest 4,000 megawatt ultra mega solar power plant in Rajasthan. There are n number of achievements in his credit and had justified his role with efficiency. I request you, sir, to take this digital platform and fulfill our knowledge. We are honored to listen to your insightful speech as chief guest address and as a keynote speaker to motivate this galaxy of intellectuals. So over to you, sir. Midha sir, over to you, sir. Ravindraji, is there still online or he got disconnected?
Just a second, sir. Just a second. Yeah, he is there.
Yeah. So I think he has to unmute and...
Midha sir
has to unmute himself.
Midha sir?
Actually, I made him co-host and I am unable to see him in
Actually,
co-host.
He was there in the participant list. Just give me a second, ma'am. Let me ask. Ma'am, can you please unmute, sir?
Yes.
Actually,
I will
he was
make
not
him
able to
co-host.
unmute.
Yeah, I will make him co-host. Actually, I had already done that, but I don't know how come.
That was a technical issue. He maybe the connection was low that time again.
Maybe. Yeah, I will make him co-host and. Yeah. Now, sir can unmute himself and sir can share the screen, etc. He's co-host now.
Yeah, actually, I have a little problem with my PC, so that is getting fixed up. So meanwhile, I'll start from the phone itself.
Okay, sir. No problem. Sir.
First of all, thank you very much, Director sir and madam, for such a generous introduction. Most of it I would like to share with all of you. I don't deserve. It is very, very generous. So don't pitch your expectations very high. But what I intend to do is share whatever I have learned during the past 45 years. I passed out of IIT Delhi in 1975. So that is about 45 years. And during this journey, I have had mentors and seniors and colleagues who taught me so much. And I had opportunities to work in different areas of business. I had opportunity to work in small businesses which were run by father and son, and also big business houses like Tata's and Ambani Group and Adani Group and many international also. So based on that, I have gathered some experience which now I am able to use in guiding these startups. So while I'll just taking a little while to fix up the connection on my laptop, I will start with you. So I would plan this session to be more interactive. I know a lot of you have already joined, and we also got more than 30 questions up front. So large part of the today's our interaction, I will devote to answering your questions. But before that, I'll just give you a brief about what we are, why such a center was thought and developed, and what are the various facilities that are being already set up, and what is the kind of network that becomes available to you for your journey from a bright idea to a successful business. So just give me, I can share the screen from maybe mobile also.
Shall I share the screen, sir, for the people?
I think if you can do it, that will be better.
Just a second, sir.
Yeah, but I have made a slight change in the order of the slides. So essentially, Ravinder ji, if you can just go forward a little, so that we will first talk about innovation and then we will talk about ourselves. Yeah, please go ahead. Go ahead. Yeah, next. Slowly now, next. Yeah. So I have been a practicing engineer all my life, more a nuts and bolts man who has worked with new ideas and new concepts. So, but just to give you a flavor of what the experts think, Peter Drucker, you must have heard, is the marketing guru. He is considered to be the market, the most knowledgeable and prolific thought leader as far as the marketing is concerned. So what he says, what is innovation according to his words? It is a economic and social phenomena rather than a technological term. So normally when we think of innovation, we think that somebody has come up with a bright idea or he has done some really remarkable new things. For example, Thomas Alva Edison invented the electric light, which brightened up the whole world and continues to do so. So innovation, it is not necessarily a technological advancement. So it is sometimes, but it is not. It is more than a simple innovation, a simple invention. So it is more to do with the economic and social phenomena. And it is how we take advantage of this new concept or new development or new technology and put it to use to improve the lives of the society as a whole. So, but when we talk of innovation, innovation has several facets, but we will focus more on it from the point of view of developing a business solution, because we are primarily thinking on how we can become a startup. And become a startup means being your own business idea, taking it to the next level, taking into a business, and becoming a job giver, then a job seeker. So as Director Saab explained, the problem of finding more and more jobs for our youth, which are now 65% of our population, is in the working age group. So we need to find lots and lots of new jobs, and also that is necessary for promoting and taking our economy to the next level, for improving the standards of living of our society. What is the core? So I'm not getting into the details, theoretical details about innovation, but what it aims to achieve. Now, the first thing what I think is it should provide the customers with what they want. Now, you must have heard about Gandhiji's famous saying that customer is the king. Customer is our God. We need the customer. It is not the other way. It is not that the customer needs us. So when we have to look at the innovation, we have to primarily see how it benefits the customer. What is it that he is looking for? But can we stop there? No. We have to also see that are there technical solutions which are feasible for it or not? I will give you an example that when we look at the stars and the moon, at some time the man thought that why are we confined to only Earth? Can we not go to the moon? And then the technologists, the scientists, they worked out the system of rockets and satellites and so on. And then finally, the man landed on the moon. But that was only for a very, very selected few. Now, you must have, some of you must have heard about the name of Mr. Elon Musk. Now, what he is saying is, I will create a colony on the Mars. So, and on the Mars, I will take certain minimum number of people, because if they want to live, if we want to create a society on Mars, I need to have minimum 1 million people, 10 lakh people. 10 lakh log honge, to tabhi wo wahan pe ek nayi duniya ek tarike se basa payenge. So this is the disruptive innovation. So he is thinking much beyond and he is planning for it. So what is not technologically feasible today may become technologically feasible maybe few years, few decades from now. So the business has to see, is it possible to create a solution based on the existing technologies or not? And last and also a very, very important, maybe the most important thing is whether this thing is financially viable. Am I creating a vehicle to go to the Mars and live there? Can people afford it? So I have given you an example which is in the extreme, but just to highlight how the innovators dream and they think big. So you have to, as an innovator, think big, very big. Sky is the limit, but at the same time, you have to keep your feet on the ground, because ultimately, as a businessman, as an entrepreneur, you are not dealing in dreams alone. Dreams are just the starting point on which you will build viable businesses which are sustainable. ये नहीं है कि ये एक साल तक एक महीने तक तो business चलेगा but उसके बाद में वो बंद हो जाएगा. ऐसे such businesses are not the target of innovation. Next. So what types of innovations that we come across? There are some innovations which are incremental innovation. That means they are small changes in the things which already exist. For example, for many years, radio taxis have been available in India also. Of course, in Europe and other advanced countries, it was available maybe 40 years. For the last 10, 15 years, you had taxi operators whom you could ring up, city cab, this cab, the other cab. So it was possible. But what Ola and Uber have done, they have expanded this concept and they have made some changes and they have come up with solutions which have Ravinder ji,
you can maybe stop
sharing now. I will share. Right?
Sure. Thank you. Just
give me a second, sir. So,
Sanaz ma'am, ma'am, can you make sir co-host?
Yes,
sir,
yes.
Joined by laptop also.
Okay, okay. So he has joined with the same name.
Yeah, same name, Vinod Mida.
Okay, okay. Yes, he can now. Sir can do it now.
Sir, you can share the screen now, sir.
Sorry.
Mida sir, you can the cell phone and laptop are like nearby, so that echo is creating, sir.
So you
can mute the cell phone, sir.
I have left from there. So gentlemen, coming back now, what is evolutionary? For example, we were using our phones, and in a limited way we were also using the these conferencing facilities to a limited extent. But in the world post COVID, we have started using this technology to a great extent, and this is how we are now interacting with each other, sitting at different places. So what we have done is we have gradually evolved this innovation to use it for a much broader platform. Then there are revolutionary and also disruptive ideas. For example, the cell phone was available, I think, maybe 20 years or maybe 30 years, but it was very expensive. And the radio broadcast, which was the essential technology behind all this, has been there for maybe more than a century, even longer. But what the scientists and the technologists have done is they have disrupted the technology to such an extent that now everyone, everywhere in the world can use it to their advantage. I'll give you some live examples of startups which are working with us, and they are doing this disruption. So what are the key elements of an innovation which can be converted into business? Is provide potential access to a wide variety of markets. Now, our innovation should be such that people will buy it. And people will buy it not only in our local market, but people will buy it across the globe, at least all over the country, so that we will have a very large market to sell and build up our business. And what is it? It makes a significant contribution to the benefits. It provides some unique benefits to the user. And
The third most important, there are many, many elements. I have selected a few which I think are most critical. So this innovation should be such that it is difficult for a competitor to imitate. If somebody can copy my innovation tomorrow, then I will be out of business tomorrow. So when I want to set up a new business, so I want to do something, I must come up with something which people find it very difficult to imitate. I'll give you two examples of the two teams working at our incubator, which are doing. Now you must have seen while traveling on the road that ambulances get stuck up on the road. No, I mean, they have a siren, they are blowing the horn, the people are, cars are in front of them. And it is not that the people in front of them do not want to give them way. They want to give them way because they realize there is somebody in the ambulance who should be reaching the hospital very quickly so that he can be saved. But lakhs of lives are lost like this. No, all of us see this and we feel that somebody should find a solution. Now, one of the young engineers like you thought that he will solve this problem. And he came to us and now he is working. And he is now working on a solution so that all the motorists and the traffic and the buses will get advanced notice that an ambulance is coming from behind you, a fire engine is coming from behind you, or a disaster management vehicle is coming from behind you, and from which direction it is coming, where it is going, it will give the motorist all this information so that he can give them way and save life. So this is a kind of innovative approach to a problem which will not only generate business, but also it will be good for the society, that people will find it very useful. People will find it very good. Lot of lives will be saved. So this is a evolutionary process based on the existing things we are developing a technology. Now, I will give you another example of another team which has developed a disruptive technology. Now the device which you are seeing behind the car is for removing the dust particles and SOX and NOX, dangerous gases, which are coming out of the vehicle. Now currently also there is solution. Now there are solution, there are filters, and there are the other technology of what is called at the tail end, you put reactive filters so that they will absorb, catalytic converters as we call them. So they convert some of these gases by absorbing them, and there are filters which catch the particles which are coming out. But what happens is they are an obstruction in the path of the gases which are coming out of the engine. Now, many of you must be mechanical engineers, so you must be knowing. Otherwise, also in other disciplines also, people must be knowing, because you are using vehicles day in and day out. So when we want to capture the particles which is coming out of the exhaust gases, it creates a hindrance to the path of the gases. So it reduces the efficiency. So the fuel consumption is more. Now this team has done something different. What happens is that in this device, the gases rotate in a certain way. That is the patented technology. But the disruption or the resistance to the path of movement is reduced, and therefore the engine efficiency is improved. So this is an example of disruptive technology. Now, can we use this device only behind the vehicle? Can we not use it in a different way, in a different design, in the chimneys? Now, all of us must have seen in the industrial areas, in the small industries sometime, which are doing things related to heating and so on. And you have paintings and other things, or electroplating, which requires you furnaces. So there is exhaust from the furnaces. So can we not capture the, can we not clean up the exhaust from these chimneys? Why not? We can do it. So with that innovation, the market expands. We have only, not only the vehicles, vehicles are also very, very large in numbers. There are 2 crore vehicles added to the Indian roads every year. Out of that, about 40 lakhs are four-wheelers alone. So there is a huge market, but with such disruptive innovations, we can address several markets, and then we can. This is just to give you a little more deeper insight into what the innovation is all about. Of course, in your regular courses, you must have read much more deeply about it. So, and I will just give on some of this, and then we will get into how we are going to do it practically, and then we will answer your questions. So who is an entrepreneur? Entrepreneur is somebody who has started with an innovative idea, who has a dream, who has a new concept. It is a product, or it is a solution, or it is a problem, like we saw, that problem that the ambulances are not able to move fast, problem that there is smoke coming out of the vehicles, which is polluting the environment and creating health hazards. So now he is set upon himself to find a solution or implement a dream solution. Now he pursues this opportunity without limitation of resources in hand. He does not have money with him. He is not an industrialist. He is not a part of a big group that money is not a problem. Entrepreneurship by definition, by design, is working on innovation. So he says, okay, I have some money. With that, I will build something. Then I will attract other people because it is a new idea. It is a very beneficial idea for the society. And then I will find the money. So he is doing something new and he is doing something different. But he is not doing it as a researcher to get a PhD or to get a Nobel Prize or to get some other recognition. He is doing it to create wealth for himself, for his team, for the economy as a whole, to create jobs and to add value to the society. These are the thoughts of thought leaders. I have just picked up a few of those things which I thought was important for us. And what more does he do? He organizes the new idea into a businesses. He manages. And above all, he assumes the risk of a business. Doing a new business is no joke. It involves a lot of risks. So this entrepreneur says, no, I will take this risk because I have a vision, I have a commitment to make this dream, to make this new concept, new innovation into a existing product and solution, which will benefit the society. So I will stop here on the basic concepts. I will now give you some idea of what we have already set up and how we can help you to fructify some of those innovations. So broadly who we are. So the Atal Incubation Center, which is supported by Atal Innovation Mission of the Niti Aayog Government of India. We are one of the 82 centers selected out of about 12,000 applications which were submitted to the Niti Aayog. And we are the, to our knowledge, we are the only one which is working on renewable energy, clean mobility, and IoT. So these are these are some of the sunrise areas which we have selected to focus on, because we cannot work on all the technologies. So we are focused on these two, three technologies, and these two, three technologies themselves have a lot of application. And you can find solution with these technologies in energy, health tech, agriculture, almost it is all pervasive. So this EMPI Institute where we are located was actually started in 1995, and it is a premier institution. It has got a lot of laurels. And above all, you see, this was created by people, some of whom you are seeing the photograph, who were nation builders in their own right. They had built big organization, and they wanted to create a Gurukul kind of concept where the students and the teachers and everyone will live together, they will learn together, they will celebrate and experience together. So it was a different concept from the typical engineering colleges, management schools. And over the years, it has done many, many innovation, many, many new things. And it has done some projects which have had a national impact. Now you can see some of the projects which were done along with the earlier our Prime Minister, Mr. Atal Bihari Vajpayee, and Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, and our current PM, our current president, and the first president, founder president is here. So it has been the hub of innovation for last 25 years, and therefore we thought of creating a new setup which will further take the youngsters on this journey beyond this. So that is how the Atal Incubation Center was conceptualized. And as I explained, we were selected. And whatever our focus areas, we are focusing on renewable energy, IoT, and new and clean mobility. Now, these three things appear to be small, maybe restrictive at first sight, but they are not. They are the sunrise area which have application virtually in anything. You name it and you can get. We have already started on the mobility front. We have already started on the renewable front. We are conducting a challenge whose link we will share with you. You all can submit your innovative ideas and then take it forward from there, which is in the health tech. Now, during this pandemic, the patients are not able to go to the hospitals even if they need to go, because they are afraid they might catch COVID. Now the thought was, can we bring the hospital to the home? Can we do some of those things which are done in the hospital? Can we do it through this remote technology? Can we test some of these things at home and share it with the doctors? That is what the remedy challenge, remote diagnostic challenge is all about, and we welcome you to participate. So what we do is we look forward to engineering management student like yours. We also look at other innovators who are already passed and who have been working. We get people with bright ideas who are doing, wanting to do path-breaking things like the ambulance and other examples which I gave you. They come to us, and our aim is to convert them into renewable and energy entrepreneurs, to electric mobility solution providers, to energy efficiency champions, smart energy innovators, smart. So many new business opportunities have emerged so that your innovative ideas can be converted into businesses. And here we sit in the center and we provide you with the laboratories, with the facilities. I will explain it to you a little more as we go forward. How do we primarily do? We have a link with the institutions, with the corporations, with the individual experts. And we have the organization which are ready to provide finance and technology, not only in India, but also abroad. And we facilitate all this so that together convert your ideas into viable products. And one more focus area, what we, apart from these things, you see any business needs funding, they need financial support. So the model which we have built is, it is not only simply that when your product is ready, then you go in front of the investors and then you make idea to them. And then if they like, you get funding. If they don't like, you don't get funding. Approach what we have said. We have said, like, we will involve you right from the beginning. We all financing and the investor partners from the beginning. We are telling them, do you have a problem? Do you have a dream? Do you have an idea which you want people to work on? We are ready to work on those areas also. And once you give us that those area, or if you like one of the bright ideas that one of startups is having, if you like that idea, you provide seed funding, you provide initial funding so that you become a long-term partner with us. And if you have got an expertise, you can also contribute. If not in technology, you may have an expertise in that, but have been doing that business and you faced a problem. So we are ready to solve your problem so that it becomes a viable business for us. But then you get the opportunity to share the patent, and therefore you can business and you can improve the viability of the business. Friends, why we are doing that is because if we want to do things in a way that it is already being done, we will not differentiate ourselves. We will not be able to give. Incubator also, we want to innovate. As a incubator also, we think ourselves as a startup because we have also started a year and a half back. Of course, there have been another year and a half of operating as an incubator. Even before we got selected by the Niti Aayog, we were doing some of these activities already. So this is a innovation that we are bringing to Engeli for that one day. The Fab Lab enabled rapidly. But before that, we want you to utilize the simulation facilities that you can virtually create your product design, you can improve it, and you can test it, and then bring it to the Fab Lab and create it into a product. So you save a lot of time. Create a prototype, wo kaam nahi kiya, usme ye problem aa gaya, usme ye cheez humne sochi nahi thi, is wajah se we face this problem. So all that is done on a simulation platform for which we have very, very advanced tools which are available. And the artificial intelligence is now becoming part of it, part of every solution. So we have created a special lab for AI solution where you work along with under the mentorship. And once you have created a new prototype, where do you go and create what we call a live lab? So if you have created, this is a solar and EV charging lab. So if you have created a solution related to solar plant, you can test it. If you have created a solution related to electric vehicle, test it. you can test it on the campus itself. And we go outside this, and that is what we are focusing on. So the other thing, what unique thing what we have created is, you have a knowledge base. You have some mentors, experts at the incubation center. But is that enough? No, that is not enough. Because you may have thought of something which is totally unique, about which you need experts from the industry. You need experts from, for example, the national labs. For example, we have a partnership with CREATE. We have signed a partner and get expert guidance from the National Aeronautical Laboratory experts, where you can use their lab to test your products. National Agro Foundation, for example, has 16,000 farmers as their members. Now, if you are building a solution for farmer, you can front with your idea. We can go and talk to them and ask them, sir, ye bataiye whether this is the right idea to work on. Or aisa na ho ke we work on it for one full year, for 1.5 years. At the end of it, we find it is not useful. So please tell what problem you are facing. We will find solution to your problem so that we don't have a problem. He's waiting. He's helping you to other. Now, some of the partners are not so big, because if you want to build a small, for example, prototype, or if you want to build a unique electronic board, companies like Device can help you. They are focused on electric mobility. There are, for example, the Onyx or Innovity, which is in the energy efficiency. You have a Romeo Power, which is focused on the battery technology. You have an C&S Electronics on control engineering. They can help you. SS Rana and company, which can help you on how to trademark, how to, you have, example, automation anywhere, which can help you to build a bot. You have Typhoon Hill, which has a unique platform on how to quickly develop your this thing. And there are many others which are not. You have, of course, Meghraj, who can help you get the capital which you need. So all are not there on the website. And going forward, we will onboard. We will go and ask them to become partners when we know what you need. So our focus is to work on your dreams, which are now our dreams as a mother organization. So what you need, we will try to create. Jaisa hota hai na, that if some student is weak in chemistry or in maths, so the parents seek by isko tuition, isko guidance, maths ki, chemistry ki dhundo. Usi tarike se hum dekhte hain ki in which area now you need guidance. So we will go to the industry and facilities which we don't have, but so you get a co-working space in which you can work and rub shoulders with other. You can work, of course, remotely, because we are totally connected. You can, if you want to live on the campus, we have got hostel facilities also, as you can live in a green environment, and the facilities are open just across within the campus, and you can use them any time of the day, because we also live, my colleagues, Mr. Mukesh, Mr. Ravinder Yadav, who are there, and myself and our president, we all virtually live on the campus. So you can knock on our door at 12 o'clock at night and say, sir, ye main so nahi pa raha because mere ko ye problem samajh mein nahi aa rahi. And we'll be happy to, because we are the people, we ourselves believe in 24/7 working. And we create lot of, we have lot of events in which you can come into contact with different people, in which you can display your products, and you can network with people, and who will see your ideas, who will guide you, and we will reach out to many more. So we have a small team which you can see, but with over 90 plus years of experience in innovation and other things. And our network is our big extended team. And like, for example, as a partner organization, faculty of your institute, we want to onboard some of them, I think, are already part of our mentor list. And the others who are willing, they will become our team. So you are also our extended team. That is why we suggested, and I think Dr. Ayub, madam, and director sir is thinking in terms of creating a innovation, entrepreneurship, startup cell at your institute, which will work very closely with the Atal Incubation Center. And together we will take, so that all the time you don't have to come to the incubator. When you want to utilize your specialized facilities, then you will come and use it. And the other thing which Dr. Yu, madam, also mentioned in our introduction is, when you are doing a project in your third year, in your fourth year, it should not only become and remain a project report. We should be able to do it in a way and also take it forward so that we build a business on that idea. It is not only enabling you to create, to get your degree. It is required for that. You must do it with all the rigor that is required, but you should take it forward through this cell, through this incubator, and build a business of your own, because that will also focus you to do a project which is much more meaningful than just putting something together, and it will give you more satisfaction. Even if you don't build a startup business, you take up a job, no issue. But while doing the project, you should do it as if you have to build it into a business. And I can assure you, young friends, based on the 45 years of experience, I have been part of a very big organization, but I have operated like a startup. From the day one to my day, I have operated like a startup within that big organization, because the pleasure of creating something, pleasure of innovation, is unique. And with that, you contribute to the organization that you work for. If you build up your own business, you generate wealth, you generate jobs, you generate immense satisfaction for yourself. But even if you work as with the setup of a startup, you will create innovations which will benefit the organization and which will help you progress faster in your job also. It is a mindset which we are inviting you to inculcate in yourself. It is how you think. It is how you live. It is how you... So I will... This is broadly what I had to tell you. I think, what is the time like? Let me see. Okay. We are already, I think, madam, I will hand over to you. So whoever wants to ask a question, I mean, you can decide, and they can unmute. You can permit them to unmute, and then I will try to answer. So first of all, thank you very much for so patiently hearing this out. I always share that people who have long experience, also there is a disadvantage because they have stories to tell. So old people like me, believe me, I am only old at in terms of number of years, with the grace of God and with good wishes of friends like you. I am very young at heart. I still have many dreams to innovative ideas, but now I need your help. I need your muscle to do it, to run. I can guide you, and I will also run with you partly, as my friends Mukesh and Ravinder will bear me out. It is only after Corona that I thought I have to be careful, otherwise I work with them 24/7, because what drives me is that pleasure of innovating something, pleasure of doing something new. And that is why I am able to say with that conviction of 45 years, you joined this stream, you joined this innovation mission, which Director Sir and Madam has the possibility they have created for you in your organization. And we are there to support all their efforts and all our efforts. We are now one team to support all of you. Thank you very much. And all our support, good wishes, blessings, stay safe, stay blessed. And let us create something unique of which we will be proud, of which our organization will be proud, and out of which society will benefit. So thank you very much. And over to you, Madam.
Thank you very much, sir. Let me check the chat box. I will first we'll take the questions from chat box, and we will ask participants also, those who are having their doubts, they can unmute themselves and they can ask. So let me check from chat box first. When you were discussing initially, that time somebody has asked the question in chat box. I don't know whether he or she got it clarified or not. Won't it put a significant amount of back pressure on the engine? When you were explaining at the beginning, that time somebody has asked this question.
Yeah. So what is his name, if I may know?
Okay. Won't it put a significant amount of back name? Pressure?
What is the name? Kaushik. Subhash Kaushik, right?
No. Ibu Hatela.
Ibu, let me, you see, the conventional filters create a lot of pressure. And that is what this innovative idea, disruptive technology overcomes. It makes the gases circulate in a way that they separate out the particles on the way. So in the present solutions, the inline filters exert that pressure, which these people have removed in their patented technology. Does it answer your question, or you want to ask something more?
Maybe it
may.
If he or she has not clarified, then he or she will ask it again.
Okay.
So we'll go through the next question. Shalini Singh is asking, today technical institutions and universities in India are distributing lakhs of BTech, MTech, PhD degrees every year. And in every course, there is mandatory project work and research paper publication in final year or final semester. But not even 5% of these projects and research publications are converted into practical applications. Why is there so much gap between hypothesis and practicality? Do these technical institutions need not to introspect themselves?
Yeah. That is a brilliant question, but that has been over there for decades. You are right. You see, the academic institutions have a mandate. They have to create your knowledge base and to some extent your skill base, right? So while they are focused on it, they are not able to focus on the other aspects of, and that is where, as I explained, we are coming in. We are coming in with exactly the same thought what you have. That is why we are saying you take up a project with the idea that you will convert it into a business. So once you start with that idea, you will receive mentoring maybe in your fourth year, maybe in your third year, maybe even earlier. So we are not putting any condition that you must be a fourth year student or a pass. So we are wanting to now solve this basic issue itself, so that more and more of these projects should actually become viable products and not remain a project report. This is what our dream is. This is what our effort is, and we are fully committed to it, and we welcome you. Not only you, all people who are listening to us, and please take it to all your friends. We welcome all innovative ideas, and we want to precisely move on the path that you are asking. Thank you very much for asking this.
Yeah, thank you, sir. Let me add something into it. May I, sir?
Please. I am by no means the only epitome of knowledge. I think I am the least of all. I have some nuts and bolts experience, but so please feel free to add.
No, actually, just I wanted to add that as Shalini Singh was asking that there should be some why there is a difference between hypothesis and practicality right now. So right now we are focusing on that only, and because looking at this problem only, we have organized this particular webinar, that let not our project be in the piece of papers, let it come out, let it be in the form of product, or let it be in the form of it should have some social relevance, and it should be used by community. So we basically with this aim only, I think AIC is also working on that particular aim, and we are also establishing the Innovation Incubation Center with that particular aim only, and even our new education policy is also focusing on that aspect, that we should have we should go with practicals, we should be more towards practical, let it not be the paperwork. Am I right, sir?
Just a small listing. Paperwork, yeah. To the extent of knowledge and rigor,
yes.
that is welcome.
Yes.
But I totally agree with you that it should not only remain a paper. It should be a live project. And a live,
yes,
and I'm sure students will enjoy it. Yeah. Next, please.
Yes, sir. So next is, I think no questions are there in chat box. Let me ask the participants, whoever, if anybody from participants, if they have any questions, they can unmute themselves and they can ask. I think
Hello. Ma'am, yeah. I had a question.
Yeah, please.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you for the opportunity, ma'am. Sir, thanks for the enlightenment, sir. Thanks a lot, sir. You're very humble, sir. Thanks a lot. Sir, I just had a question. Let's say I have two types of ideas. The first one is about the idea, let's say, regarding an application, which is highly in demand. I'm just giving an example. That first idea is based on what's in demand currently. And the second idea is what I have a lot of skill set. The second might take a lot of time and a lot of input from my end. And for the first idea, which is in demand, it will be getting support from the other people. So which one should I pursue? And if, let's say, that I can pursue only one idea, which path should I choose? Was the question clear?
Oh, good. Very, very interesting. Very interesting question. So I will also, without going, because we when we sit down and discuss, then more nitty-gritties will come. But I will say that you first pursue the idea which is in demand, because ultimately you have to create business and wealth, as we saw. And then, but you don't lose sight of the other idea. Keep it as your long-term vision. So sky is the limit, as I said. So first idea, you implement quickly, before other people beat you to the winning line, and you create some little more innovation into it, that it remains in demand for some time, and you keep it as your vision, and you then start working with it, because if you, with the first one, you generate some resources, it will be easier for you to work on the other one also. Thank you. Does it answer or does it confuse you more?
Totally, sir.
Yeah, sir. One question is there in chat box. Shubha Srivastava is asking, as a customer, how can we trust on startup products over any established brand? For example, Micromax entered the mobile market with lots of advertising and marketing, but quitted the Indian market overnight silently. So people who bought the product are struggling for after-sales services. However, it is again re-entering the Indian market again. So our question is, as a customer, how can we trust on startup products?
Yeah. So this is a challenge I faced about, let me say, 14 years back, when Chinese were for dumping power plant products, and even a big company like BHEL was finding it very difficult to stay in the market, right? So your question, what we brought into focus of the customer was, what is the long-term support that is available from the vendor, right? Secondly, if you run into a problem, is the vendor going to support you? And the third thing which you, as a customer, you should look from the customer's point of view is, what is the innovation, what is the extra value added that the product is giving you? Because somebody who is giving you a run-of-the-mill product will not have invested enough in recognizing the technology. So your trust level as a customer, I would say, if I were to buy a thing, I would not go for somebody who is just selling run-of-the-mill things, because his main aim is to capture the market and make some quick money. So this I am explaining from both sides, right? As a customer, you should look for something which is innovative, that is, which is adding, if you have to select out of a range of products, right? As a customer, you have many options. So look for something which is giving you more innovation, more value added, and the stability and the availability of the vendor. And you can use the same thing when you want to sell your new products to the customer. When you go to the customer, you give the example which you have given me, right? That supposing he is giving you run of the mill. I am, as an innovator, as a new startup, am giving you X, Y, Z, these three things extra. And I am going to listen to you. I am going to be on your call. Whenever you run into a problem, I am going to be there to solve this problem, because I need you as a customer, right? Does it answer your question?
Okay. I think, sir, it is clarified. You have justified it properly. Mr. Jitendra Singhal has unmuted. So if you have any question, Mr. Jitendra Singhal, you can ask.
No, ma'am, not now.
Okay. So any other from participants? Chat box is over now.
Ma'am.
Yeah.
Good evening, ma'am.
Good evening.
Ma'am, I had a question that... for engineering students who are in penultimate year of their degree course, and they have a limited technical knowledge. So if they have some product in their mind and they want to bring it into the market, should they pursue a job or in that field, or go for higher studies first to enhance their knowledge, or should they directly approach the risky path of bringing it into market.
Yeah, Midha sir, please.
Yeah. So a lot of time we feel that if we should acquire some some experience and expertise and so on, and then, but when we enter the job, that is what I also thought. Let me, share my personal experience. And then it took me almost 40 years to come out and then get into the startup world, right? Of course, the organization permitted me to operate like a startup. That was fortunate for me. Otherwise, in some other organization, I would have been told to do this and not to waver. So if you have a bright idea, you are in third year, fourth year, first of all, take it as a project, because that will help you to complete your the degree requirement also. And why do you say you don't have expertise? You have all these knowledge, the plethora of knowledge in your professors and your guides. Take advantage. You see, today you can take advantage through the cell. After you leave the college, you will not, they may, some of them may still guide you, but today they are available to you. So you have an, you have a unique possibility to go to, for example, you madam or somebody else, to sir or Gautam sir, or and say, sir, I am struggling with this problem. I am now, and once you join this cell and you declare your intention to be a startup, I can assure you, all your team members will be keen to help you more. So use their expertise to, because they have deep domain knowledge. So, and bring it to a level by the time you come out of your fourth year and come to the incubator, or even maybe if you start earlier, you will be able to start your own company. It is now not essential to go through that cycle. And the danger is, if you get into that, you may not be able to come out like me for the next 40 years, although all those things have changed. But today you have these facilities. When we came out of college, we never had incubators and things like that who are ready to help us. So my suggestion would be, if you have a dream, first you do it. If you fail, then and God forbid that, and then you decide to take a job, getting a job will be easier, because they will know you are somebody who has already innovation and the spirit of enterprise in your mind. Some other startups, the big startups, will hire you. So you will have much more job opportunities also. So my suggestion is, you first pursue your dream and convert it to your business, and God willing, you will succeed. We are all there to help you, your faculty, we at the Atlee Incubation Center, lot of other mentors. We will see that you succeed. Because what is my success today? My success is in seeing you succeed. At the end of the day, if I am able to have 10, 12, 15, 30 successful businesses going out of the Atlee Incubation Center, only then government will support me. That is my mandate. So I am part of your team. I will be working along with you to see that you succeed. Your faculty will be working with you to succeed if you declare your intention. No? That's why I'm saying, discuss, you form a team, and you declare your intention to be an innovator, and see how people start helping you. Because inside, all of us had this dream. All of us have this dream, but we are not maybe finding time. Maybe we are part of the job. We have to teach. We have to prepare lessons. As an industry man, I have to submit a report. I have to see a product done. But through you, they would want to live their dreams and contribute to it. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Harsh wanted to ask some question. Hey, Harsh, are you there?
Yeah, ma'am. Thanks, ma'am.
Yeah, please.
Yeah. Thanks, Vinod sir, for great session. से मेरे पास एक आइडिया था जो मैंने अप्रैल में सबमिट किया था IIM काशीपुर में और वो सिलेक्ट भी हुआ था और 2 मंथ की ट्रेनिंग भी मिला और मैंने अपनी कंपनी इनकॉर्पोरेशन से मैंने अपनी खुद की कंपनी रजिस्टर्ड कर ली और DPIIT सर्टिफिकेट भी मिल गया। अब लास्ट में ये सर मुझे फंडिंग के लिए अप्रोच करना है तो मैं कैसे अप्रोच करूँ, हाउ टू अप्रोच एंजल फंडिंग या एंजल फंडिंग सर?
देखिए आपने वहां पे जो काशीपुर में जो इंक्यूबेटर है दे विल हेल्प यू टू फाइंड फंडिंग बिकॉज वी आर एट आवर इंक्यूबेटर, दिस इज वन ऑफ आवर जॉब्स टू अल्टीमेटली फाइंड फंडिंग बिकॉज बिना पैसे के तो बिना पेट्रोल के गाड़ी नहीं चलती ना, तो पेट्रोल जरूरी है, पहले गाड़ी जरूरी है, तो बिगर विजन इज रिक्वायर्ड फर्स्ट बट मनी इज ऑल्सो रिक्वायर्ड. So you can I think you should approach them, they will help you. Or if you want to if that program is over and if you want to join us at the incubation at the incubator, we are more than happy to then further help you.
Okay, sir. Thank you. Thank you so much, sir.
So, Harsh, we have created one option in feedback form about your queries and suggestions and all that, so that there you can put your this problem and you can contact AIC, EMPI. You can join that particular things.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah. Any other questions from participants?
हाँ जी.
सो इफ
नहीं जी अभी तो
देन आई विल आस्क डायरेक्टर सर इज स्टिल देयर ऑन बोर्ड. सो सर कैन आई हैव सम रिमार्क्स फ्रॉम यू डायरेक्टर सर?
डेफिनेटली मैडम, डेफिनेटली. वी आर रियली फॉर्चुनेट एनफ टू हैव विद अस विनोद मेडा जी हु हैड थ्रोन लाइट ऑन डिफरेंट अपॉर्चुनिटीज व्हिच आर अवेलेबल टू द यूथ for their innovative ideas and how they can be helpful in starting different startups. I'm confident that the participants might have definitely benefited because the way he presented the things in a very light note and very informative, very informative. I'm really happy from the core of my heart that he has spared his time, valuable time with us and shared his experiences because he's having all through about 40 years of the professional experience in the subject. And the participants definitely will go a long way by his advice and his experiences. And definitely it was a fruitful interaction with the participants. I congratulate the organizing committee for holding this national activity and SPIU team also, who has always been with us for organizing such activities, which is beneficial to all the students and the participants. Thank you very much, madam.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, director, sir. Let me thank Mr. Vinod Midha, sir. As rightly said, if you want something new, you have to stop doing something old. And you proved it, sir. So I wholeheartedly thank you for your inspiring, encouraging words and above all, sparing your valuable time by accepting our invitation. We wish to express our gratitude to you, sir, for being with us on this event. Thank you very much, sir. Your thought-provoking address set a perfect platform for us on this important topic of today's webinar. Thank you so much, sir, for being with us on this important day. The session feedback link I have already shared in the chat box. I request Dr. Mahavir Singh Naroka, Nodal Officer, SPIU, Uttar Pradesh, to propose vote of thanks of this webinar. Dr. Mahavir
Singh. Thank you, Sanaj ma'am. Thank you. Thanks a lot. So on behalf of the State Project Implementation Unit, Uttar Pradesh, the Bundelkhand Institute of Engineering Technology, Jhansi, and my own behalf, I would like to propose heartily vote of thanks to our mentor and the chief guest for the today's online webinar, Mr. Vinod Mehta ji, who is the CEO, Atal Incubation Center, EMPI, New Delhi, the former executive director, BHEL, for gracing this national webinar on innovation, the key for startup success, and delivered the expert talk. Thank you, sir, for your address. Your address was very meaningful and interesting. I'm sure that all the participants have taken note of your guidance and will be implemented with their organization. The suggestive action to be initiated at their level. Sir, your talk was very informative and useful for the participants who are attending this webinar from the director, BIT Jhansi, Professor A.K. Nigam ji, the TechU coordinator, and Dr. Shehnaz Ayub ji, who is the Dean R&D and the series coordinator from the BIT Jhansi. I would like to thank Dr. Anil Kumar ji, who is the state project administrator, SPIU UP, for his guidance and the support. So I also acknowledge and express my thanks to Engineer Ravindra Yadav ji, who is the technical and outreach officer, AIC EMPI New Delhi, and Dr. Atul from BIT Jhansi for their unconditional contribution towards the success of this event. I appreciate the support of SPIU officials, Mr. V.K. Singh ji, Mr. Vinish Surana ji, and others who are involved directly or indirectly in this event to make this success. I would also like to convey my thanks to the Ministry of Education, the World Bank, and the NPIU officials for their contribution toward the success of this webinar. At last, I thank all the participants who are attending this webinar from various corners of the country, because without support of them, the success of this webinar will not be possible. So once again, thanks to all for joining us. Jai Hind.
Thank you. Let me thank Dr. Mahavir Singh Naroka for his wonderful cooperation to this webinar. And also let me thank Engineer Ravindra Yadav, Technical and Outreach Officer, Atal Incubation Center, EMPI, for his tireless cooperation. I must acknowledge the efforts of my IIC BIT Jhansi student coordinators team, Shivam Maheshwari, Achal Sharma, Mudit Gupta, Durgesh Kumar Prajapati, Mayank Kumar Singh, Ali Nazar, and other 25 student coordinators from all the BTech streams of my institution. I must thank Almighty for smoothing my way by removing the hurdles whatsoever in my path and making the task successful. Thank you so much. Thank you, Midha sir. Thank you, Director sir. Thank you, Ravindra ji. Thank you, Dr. Mahavir ji. Thank you, all participants. Yeah, please.
Can we have a group photo with all the participants?
Yes. Like, yes. If we can... I'll ask all the participants to please put their cameras on so that we can capture this beautiful moment. I am taking the screenshots. You also, Ravindra ji, you also take.
Yes, ma'am. Done, ma'am.
Yeah. Yeah. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Ravindra ji. And I have already shared the feedback. I will be there on board for another 3 minutes so that everybody should get. This link to take care of all the participations from across the country. Thank you, Dr. Atul. Director, sir. Yeah, Director, sir, We'll wait for another 2-3 minutes. Thank you so much, sir.
Okay, madam. Okay.
Thank you very much.
Yeah.
Look forward to taking it further with you. Thank you, madam.
Yeah, thank you, sir.
For all the...
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much, sir, for sparing your valuable time, sir.
We look forward to working further on these initiatives what you have created. Thank you. Have a good day.
I would request you that today you didn't get sufficient time to talk to director, sir. Sometime you both get some time and you talk to each other. I think instead of, you know, mediating me in between, it would be
obviously be of much greater help. So we let's organize a small call at director sir's convenience. We'll do that. Thank you so much. Have a good day. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Yeah, thank you, sir. Thank you. Thank you very much, sir. Yes, so parts can leave now. Those who have already filled up the feedback link, because it will ease us for certification. Feedback link, the meeting now, if they want. Thank you, Director, sir.
Thank you, madam. Thank you for nicely organizing the event.
Thank you, sir, for sparing your valuable time with us.
Thank you, madam. Thank you.
Having good words, motivating words, encouraging words.
Sir, 20% 20% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40% 40%